Hello guys, my name is Josh, and today is just going to be a quick video of my personal opinions on the coronavirus. As a disclaimer, I'm no medical expert or professional in any way, so I'm going to link the CDC's website in the description of this video. There, you can find all of the expert information and everything you need to know about coronavirus. So that'll be in the description for you to check out, and I very much recommend you do that. This is just going to be my personal opinions on the virus and how people are reacting to it, at least the way I'm seeing it. When I think of coronavirus, I think of the people that are freaking out over it. And there's two different ways of taking something like this. You can freak out about it, or you can just take it seriously in a manner without freaking out about it. I was watching the news. I was watching it when they had first announced it on NBC. I was like, oh, it's a new virus. They're probably gonna come up with a cure. No one saw this coming. But when something comes up this fast, the first thing your mind wants to do is freak out about it. You just gotta take a step back and look at the facts for yourself. Because the news is always going to tell you the bad stuff, the death toll and everything. Very rarely will they mention the recovery and everything, like, unless they're talking about the death toll and the statistics about the whole virus. That's when they'll put in there, yeah, and this amount of people have been recovered. But then they'll go right back to the next case saying how places such as Italy and all of them are just doing terrible and that everyone should just be worried about it. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't be worried about it. But I'm saying that you shouldn't freak out about it and let it take over your entire state of mind. You should take it seriously. Look at the websites of the CDC, things from your government and state officials, anywhere that's official. I don't recommend you going to a place like the news outlets because all they're gonna tell you is the bad things that are going on. Yeah, they'll always throw in like what the CDC has quoted or what they've said, but most of the time it's always something bad. But what you should do is go to the CDC or your government state official's website, and they'll tell you all the steps for what you can do to prevent the virus in your area. I think that especially the younger population be more tame about this situation. They're taking it as an opportunity to show their defiance. And even if your immune system is stronger than those, all it takes is for you to go to the store and somebody standing in line with you at checkout, and someone who has underlying health condition that can just pick that up, and then that's it. You know, that'll be on you. You may not even know it, but it will have been because of you. Just take a second before you go to a party. Just take a second to think about it. Is it worth it to go out and to risk not only your life but others? In the end, it's your choice. Whether it's a wise choice or not, it's all gonna be up to you. One thing I really am confused about in this whole coronavirus thing is why toilet paper? That's the one thing I've just wondered. Why toilet paper? It's technically an essential, you know. I can understand if it was like Kleenex or if it was like food items. I went to the store and I still saw racks and racks of beef, but the toilet paper aisle was gone. And I was like, wait, these people are buying toilet paper more than they're buying frozen foods and like canned vegetables or just canned food. My first thought would be like to buy your essential foods and stuff so you could stock up. And I mean, I get toilet paper, but I just didn't know that toilet paper would be the top priority in a way. it kind of makes me question why toilet paper. I still have not found an explanation to why toilet paper is the number one priority for this. I've not heard one doctor or anyone recommend buy toilet paper as the number one thing. And, you know, stock up on all the essentials, especially toilet paper. That should be the thing you buy. I have not heard that. I don't know why toilet paper is the number one priority. Don't overbuy because others need it too. Like, just because there's a pandemic going on doesn't mean you should go and buy 50,000 rolls of toilet paper. You shouldn't do that because others need it. And they may not be able to get it just because people are hoarding. It's pretty sad that some people are actually hoarding and buying, not even really caring about others. I get that it's good to stock up. It's really good to stock up in case of an emergency, but there's two different things from stocking up and hoarding when it's all about you and forget everyone else. You know, that's just not right. In essence, my thoughts about all of this, what we should do is just take a step back, look at the government officials' websites, don't freak out about it, take it seriously, be vigilant. If there's a stay-at-home order issued for your town or area, then just follow the guidelines they set for you. Whatever they may be, just follow them. And if you don't know what they are, then find out, whether it be on the internet or just call a government official. No matter what you have to do, just find a way to make sure you do all the proper steps that are placed in front of you and make sure everything is done properly. That's just my personal opinions on the coronavirus. And as I said, a reminder, I will be linking the CDC guidelines for coronavirus in the description on their website. And you guys definitely need to go check this out for yourself, because I'm not a medical professional. This is just my thoughts on it. Now, in my life, other stuff that I've been up to, I'm collaborating with another YouTuber. He has 100 and something subscribers, and I'm writing a coronavirus song. I'm producing and writing the lyrics for it. And it's just going to be some of the guidelines that the CDC have set, and I'm just going to make them into an approachable, fun way of learning, sort of. So just a catchy song. Maybe it's all it takes right now for the world to, you know, get it stuck in their head. But I'm in the process of writing a song, and that will soon be up. So I am collaborating with another YouTuber right now. I'm going to link his channel in the description, and you guys can go check that out. As soon as this song is finished, I'm going to get it up for all of you guys to hear. But thank you guys for watching this video. Please check out the CDC website in the description. Just don't freak out. Take it seriously and stay safe. Thank you guys. I love you.